life is a game. A game will be playing, man. You wanna know the name? Alright, I'll tell you. It's called Calypso. Time has come, it's time to catch the sun.
I am Calypso.
The party has begun, come on and have some fun.
Sicily, Africa, under the sky of blue.
Calypso has a rhythm that can make a dream come true. Lost in the moment, all God's children are the same. Life is for the living and Calypso.
Introducing the 20th Annual Sporting Chance Calypso Cricket Festival in association with Virgin Active, I&J, and media partner SuperSport Let's Play. This year, more than 3,000 children from communities around Cape Town travelled to the coast to take part in the 20th Annual Sporting Chance Calypso Cricket Festival. And as Sporting Chance celebrated 20 years of Calypso cricket, so too did Indians of South Africa celebrate being a great part of our society for 150 years. Coupled with that celebration, the Indian cricket side was here to play the Proteas in a couple of tests. And the little master, Sachin Tendulkar, and other members of the Indian cricket side took time out of their test schedule to join a lucky group of Calypso kids to share tips with the youngsters. Born from a desire to introduce large numbers of kids to cricket and bring the various communities and cultures of South Africa together, MD of Sporting Chance, Brad Bing, explains how it all started.
It started in 1990, and the beautiful thing was we got together as sportsmen of South Africa and turned around and said, surely we as sportsmen of South Africa can put together a project ahead of unity to show that we're sincere about unity in South Africa. And guys like Barney Muhammad and Clinton Ravens and Vinnie Barnes, who's now our national bowling coach, and Nazim White and Dion Kemp and myself, turned around and said, how do we make this all happen? And then we approached a guy called Ezra Kagwe, who's the director of development here in the Western Cape, and we asked him to source us 200 children from Langa community, and that's how it all started. And 20 years later, we've worked with, I think we're around about 100,000 kids over the past 20 years. I think we've had a tremendous success in spotting talent over the years. You know, 43 kids have come through the system to go on to play provincial cricket at schoolboy level. We're delighted that a youngster called Tommy Tolakelli, who used to play for Western Province in the Cape Cobras, who's now playing for the Lions, has gone on to play for South Africa. And we were delighted to have Anton Fonseil, who's the Western Province rugby captain, be part of this festival all those years ago. So yeah, I think we've had great success.
Once again, media interest was tremendous and extensive coverage was given to the event across all forms of media. And the Cape's number one radio station, KFM 94.5 FM, sent their public participation team, the Ground Patrol, to join the children on the beach and hand out tennis balls to each and every child on the beach that day. The festival is a unique and fun adaptation of the conventional game. Employing most of the rules of cricket, Calypso cricket is played on the beach with two teams of 10 players each. The spirited game originated in the West Indies, where it's played between different villages that gather in their hundreds for the event. Participation in the program is from the ages of 8 to 15, offering learners the opportunity to engage in a healthy and fun-filled lifestyle throughout these critical formative years. The communities and clubs are therefore an integral part of the program. Cyril Pelston, a coordinator from Manenberg, one of the more impoverished and crime-ridden communities in Cape Town, describes the importance of this festival for the children.
I think it's essential for us, you know, involving leadership positions in our communities to get young children off the street, encourage them to firstly be involved in positive activities such as cricket. A lot of the kids that we're having on this program are kids that come from disadvantaged communities. They're exposed to negative things such as substance abuse, crime, gangsterism, overcrowding and housing issues. And I think this is a positive outlet for our kids.
Dane Villas, Cape Cobra's wicketkeeper and all-rounder, joined the festival on the beach and had this to say.
A day like this is very important, especially for me. I mean, I grew up with, I was very lucky, I grew up with a bat in my hand, and also just brings back the enjoyment of the game, the fun and every sort of aspect that you get with cricket. The future of Southern cricket is very high. If there's lots of programs like this, I know that they've got this beach cricket, they've got the street cricket, so there's so many options and so many available options out there for young kids today that they can only get better.
Not only were the beaches busy, but behind the scenes, people were busy as well. A big thank you to Rotary International and the Rotarians that came to assist us on each day. An integral part of the whole day, as has been mentioned, is to get the children to understand how important it is for them to lead healthy lifestyles. And this was enhanced by trainers from various Virgin Active gyms spending the whole day on the beach. From the start of the day, leading everyone in a warm-up, to spending time with each group of children in teams waiting to bat, doing basic exercises, to being an invaluable part of the vibe session at the end of the day. Robin Moore, head of Club V for Virgin Active, elaborates.
Our main role for getting involved in the Calypso Cricket with Sporting Chance is to bring activity to young children. Virgin Active's initiative for 2011 is to combat obesity in our younger kids. And this is a perfect way to get a kick started. So Virgin Active is here on the beach today with our instructors leading the kids and doing some fun activities while they're sitting around batting all day.
At the end of the day, this established annual event is all about the children. Here are just a few of the comments recorded.
To always come here from the community to learn about other children.
I learn lot of things here, so I enjoy today because my brain is so cool, yeah.
The things that make me excited is that I play cricket. Cricket is my favorite sport.
It's from, we mixed some teams from other areas, some my friends that I know.
I love things, and I enjoy to be here today, and I have seen the friends that I haven't seen, and I play cricket nice, I enjoy my day.
The day's proceedings each day were brought to a close with the traditional vibe dance.
We gonna get funky, 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 funky. Everybody clap your hands, clap, 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 clap your hands.
Then hundreds of happy, sun-soaked, fun-filled smiles headed for home after receiving a snack lunch and goodie bag filled with stationery and hygiene items and a tennis ball to keep on playing. So, on behalf of the children, a huge thank you to founders and facilitators, Sporting Chance, in association with sponsorship and support from Virgin Active, I&J and media partners SuperSport Let's Play. As always, Sporting Chance, striving for a healthy lifestyle for the youth of our wonderful country.